Hi guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to install Android Studio on your Windows 11 computer and also set up the Android emulator so you can test apps or just explore Android without needing a real phone. It's a very simple process and I will walk you through every single step. So let's get started. Alright, first let's download Android Studio. So for that, open your browser and in the search bar you need to just type Android Studio and hit enter. You will see the official Android developer site at the top, usually starts with the developer.android.com. So just click on that. Once the page open, from here you need to download Android Studio, which is the official IDE for Android apps development. On this page, look for the button that says Download Android Studio Mewcat Features Drop. This is the latest version available right now. Just go ahead and click on that to move to the download page. A new page will appear asking you to read and agree to the terms and conditions. Just scroll down and tick the checkbox that says I have read and agreed to the terms. And then click the Download Android Studio button. And you can see the file size is quite large, around 1.2 GB. So depending on your internet connection, it might take some time. So be patient while the download completes. Okay. Once the download is complete, go to your download folder. You will see the setup file for the Android Studio. Just double click on it to start the installation. If you see a message saying the app you are installing is not from the Microsoft Store, just click on Install Anywhere to continue. Now the Android Studio setup wizard will open. Click on Next to proceed. On the next screen, it will ask you to choose components. Make sure both Android Studio and Android Virtual Device are checked. These are required to run the emulator, so don't uncheck them, okay? Then click Next again. Now it will ask you where to install the software. You can leave it as the default location unless you want to install it somewhere else. I will leave it as it is and click Next. Then click Install to begin the installation process. The installation may take a couple of minutes. You will see a progress bar showing how much has been completed. So just sit back and let it finish. Once it's done, you will see the message saying the setup was completed successfully. Great. Now make sure the checkbox that says Start Android Studio is ticked. Then click Finish. Next, it may ask whether you want to share user statistics with Google. That's completely optional. I'm going to click Don't Send. After that, the Android Studio window will appear with a screen that says Welcome to Android Studio. This is the main launch screen you can see, where you can start new projects. Okay, so now we are going to set up our Android emulator. On this welcome screen, look at the bottom right corner and click on More Action. Then here you need to click on Virtual Device Manager. If this is your first time, the AVD manager will be empty. So let's create a new virtual device. Okay, so click on the plus icon and select Create Virtual Device button. Here you will see a different category of device like phone, tablet, Wear OS, desktop and so on. Since we are going to emulate a phone, so you need to click on Phone from the left panel. Now choose any model you like from the list. I am going to pick Pixel 9 Pro XL. But you can choose the one you prefer. Okay, once selected, click Next. Now comes the part where we select a system image. That means the Android version we want to run in our emulator. You might see several options with the different API levels. If it's your first time, I recommend selecting the latest stable version. So click on the download link next to it and the system image will start downloading. And again, this may take a few minutes, so wait until it finishes downloading. Okay. Once the download is finished, you can rename your device here or just leave it as it is. Everything else can stay at the default settings. Okay, then finally click Finish. Congratulations, you have just created your first virtual Android device. It should now appear in the list of available devices in the AVD manager. To start the emulator, just click on the play icon on the right side of your virtual device. And the emulator will start booting up. This may take around 30 seconds to a minute depending on your system. Once it's fully booted, you will see a virtual Android phone on your screen. Look. You can now use your mouse to interact with it just like a real smartphone. Open apps, you can swipe, it works just like the real things. You can now open the apps like the Google Play Store to install the new apps. Or you can also open YouTube to watch video. You can interact with the emulator using your mouse just like you would with a physical phone. On the right side of the emulator window, you will see some handy controls. You can simply press the go back button from here to return to the previous screen, just like tapping the back button on the real Android phone. It's a super useful when you are navigating through apps or setting inside the emulator. You can also rotate the screen if required using the rotate button on the side panel. And if you want a closer look at something, you can even zoom in or zoom out as per your need using the zoom controls available on the emulator window. You can now open any of your favorite apps with mouse and enjoy just like you would on a real phone, whether it is Amazon, Hotstar or any other apps. There is also a button on the side to simulate the power button, just like you would do on a real phone. And if you want to close the emulator, you can simply click the cross icon at the top of the emulator window. Or you can go back to the ABT manager and click the stop button to shut it down from here. Later, if you want to launch the emulator again, simply search for Android Studio in your Windows search bar. Then open the app. Once open, go to the more action. Then select virtual device manager. And from here, you need to click start on the device you created. And that's it guys, you have successfully installed Android Studio and set up an Android emulator on your Windows 11 PC. Now you can start building and testing apps, or you can just explore Android for fun. If this video helped you out, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon so you never miss out on our future tech tutorials. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.